Hello. Good afternoon, everyone. This is Kiran Prasad from Fundamental Research. Today, I came out with an reinitiation report on MOIL. It's a Mineral Ore India Limited. It's a reinitiation report because of the fact that we are already having initiation report, which was published in the year 2014. Since then, dynamics of market has significantly changed. So I thought of coming out with reinitiation report on this particular company. I believe that report, you might have been in possession of the report. If not, then it will shortly be reaching to you all. In the meantime, I would like to give you the gist of the whole investment thesis. So talking about the company, MOIL, it's a public sector unit having a mini ratna status, and it is having 45% market shares in manganese ore productions, and it is the only company which has been producing high-grade mineral ore called ferroalloys. No other company in India is having that capability to produce high-grade manganese ore. As a matter of fact, India produces manganese ore of the grade of the 30 to 35% manganese content, which is believed to be lower grade manganese ore only. While in steel industries, it is medium to high grade manganese ore has higher applications. So ferroalloys is supposed to be high grade manganese ore with 45% of manganese content. And then we have silico grade manganese ore, which will have something around 45%, 35 to 45% of manganese ore. So in that sense, MOIL is in at advantageous positions for the reason that the company produces high grade as well as medium grade manganese ore, while others are not producing too. Then, talking about the rationale of investing to this company, enjoys 45% market shares, and the kind of boom we are seeing in steel industry, manganese ore demand prospect is basically linked with the demand prospect of steel, because 95% of manganese ore is used into steel industries. So we have virtually agreement with regard to the fact that there is cyclical uptrend in metals and mining sectors. So with the growth in metals demand, steel demands, the demand for manganese ore is going to rise significantly. MOIL, because of the fact that it produces high grade manganese ore, ferroalloys, as well as medium grade manganese ore, silico, so it is in advantageous positions to meet the high grade and medium grade manganese ore demand from the steel industry. As a matter of fact, steel industry has to count on South Africa and Australia for this high grade manganese ore, because of the fact that we have dearth of supply of high grade and medium grade manganese ore. Keeping this fact into account, the management has decided on going for setting up ferroalloys plant, two ferroalloys plant with a capacity of 75,000 per metric ton productions, as well as 25,000 per metric tons productions. So this will enable company to meet requirement of ferroalloys from steel industry. Then, in terms of financial health of the company is a debt-free company having no interest at cost and has been experiencing high capital inflow, and it has regularly been paying high dividends, and return ratio has also been quite impressive. It is generating something around, as per the financial year of FY18, it generated 15% return on equity and 17% on return on capital employed and 13% on return on assets. So return is quite impressive from the company side. And then one more fact that could drive the sales of this company, MOIL, is the fact that the company is into this company produces electrolytic manganese dioxide, which has greater application in dry cells. And the fact that there is boom with regard to, if not boom in India, in other part of the world, there is boom with regard to battery-led vehicles. And soon in India also, this kind of boom is likely to take place because of the fact that government is having plan to replace all the vehicles by battery-led vehicles by 2030. So this is going to contribute in significant rise in sales of the company. Talking about operating performance of the company, company has so far been generating sales growth at a rate of CAGR of 7%. And we believe, taking into consideration the kind of demand is there in steel industry, and with the leadership positions, MOIL will be able to generate sales at the rate of CAGR 15% over FY 2018-20. We believe that the cost advantage, low cost production capability of the company because of centrally located its mines and efficiency that it has brought in its operations, the company will be able to generate higher EBITDA and margin will be coming around, EBITDA margin will be there around 44 by FY20. PAT is also expected to respond to the fact that the company is having no finance cost, and greater component of other income is interest income. Company is high cash balance with this, and it is generating good interest income over the period of times. All these factors will contribute PAT to grow at faster pace, and EPS will also be responding to the growth of the PAT. So with this, factoring all this rationale of investment, we have valued the stock on the basis of 5 years average 1 year forward PE, that comes around 10.2 and of 20 EPS, and that thereby we have arrived at the target price of 232, which with the potential of 38% upside. Having said that, the risk to this valuation is likely slowdown in China, though the government has taken various measures to arrest any slowdown there in China. But then we fear that if Chinese economy is contracting too, then it will have overall impact on the demand for steel, and for that matter, demand for the manganese ore as well. And then we are also concerned about the cyclical nature of the demand of steel industry. So, finally, we are really suspicious about that lingering out of trade war situation that we are into. Though there has been development with regard to during the G20 meeting, world leaders reached that agreement with regard to postponing this issue for next 3 months. So that has given rise of positive sentiment at the marketplace, and given the backdrop of positive sentiments, we feel that this metal and mining sector will be doing excellently well. Thanks a lot.